Assalamualaikum everybody. It is me Aiman Azlan. Welcome to another video on YouTube. Ma hoi. All right. So this video I want to answer this one question from Ayu. So Ayu asked on Instagram, how to find work-life balance when my job's working hours is more than normal. Okay, Ayu, I don't know what your job is, but basically you have too many hours doing job and not enough hours of home time. So what should you do? Okay, a few things. Because your question is general, I have to give you a general answer. Okay, Ayu, and also for others who are listening, the first thing that I would like to mention is that you only have 24 hours. Sounds like, you know, duh, but I have to mention it because people may have this perception that, oh, I need more time. No, you don't need more time because you cannot have more time. 24 hours is the amount of time that's fixed. That's the one thing that cannot change in this scenario. 24 hours, it cannot change. Okay, so put that aside. Okay, you cannot have more time, but what you can have is more efficiency, more discipline, and better time management. So those three things you can control, right? More discipline, more efficiency, and better time management. That's the second part of this answer. So you can work on your time management skill, you can work on your commitments, how you delegate your tasks, and how you delegate the number of hours to each task, and how do you prioritize your day. And time management is a very huge topic, so I recommend that you attend classes, read books, have a mentor who can help you, things like that. So you can increase your efficiency by having those time management skill top-notch lah, basically. So you can control that, so within 24 hours you can get more done with more efficiency, basically. And you don't have to sacrifice any parts of your life, because with efficiency you can delegate it better, knowing that you have a system that works for you, for your own lifestyle. And that's the key thing about time management, is that there's no one answer fits all. So you have to modify whatever time management skill that you are trying to practice into your own personal life. Like, my lifestyle is different, so my kind of time management and how I delegate my hours is a bit different. So your time is different because your lifestyle is different. So you have to tweak and modify whatever time management skill that you learn to your own specific needs. And if one time management method doesn't work for you, don't give up, because there are so many other time management methods out there. It's plural. So find the one that works for you and just stick to it. You can even like tweak and modify to create your own system. That's the best way to do it. Create your own system that works for you, for your situation. All right. So number one, you cannot have more time. 24 hours is 24 hours. Number two, you can control your efficiency by having better time management. Number three, okay, this is a bit difficult, all right? You choose your career. Do not hate me, please. Okay. Hear me out, okay? The reason why it's not easy for me to say that, even though it sounds like easy, right? You choose your career. Because I understand circumstances. I am aware of circumstances. There are people who are working this dead end, very stressful jobs, and they cannot get out of the job because they have to pay the bills. They have to support their family, right? So you can't simply say, oh, you choose your job. If you don't want this job, get another job. So it's not as easy as it sounds. So I understand context. I understand circumstances. But having said all of that, this message is still true. You choose your career. So if this particular job that you're doing right now is so stressful for you, to the point where even with the best time management, you still cannot cope with it, and it is bringing negative effects on your family life, on your personal life, even on your me time, then you have to make a difficult choice, either to stay on that job or look for another job. And looking for another job, it doesn't mean that you quit today and just tomorrow be like, okay, nak buat apa sekarang. No, you need a plan, you need a strategy. If if you've done everything else and you still cannot like live a sane life, then you have to create a plan, an exit plan. It doesn't mean that you quit today, all right? Have an exit plan. So like say 6 months down the road, you make a plan. Okay, in 6 months, I want to quit this job, but I need to have something first as a safety net. Because when I quit, when I jump out, I need that safety net to catch me as I fall. So that safety net could be a side business, a side hustle, or maybe you try to send your resume to other companies or whatever it may be, so that you can earn enough income to support your family. Because again, you still need to support your family and yourself. So have an exit plan, right? At the end of the day, maybe after your long hours of work, you can spend some time, like half an hour or 1 hour in front of a computer, doing some research about what other options that you can do with your life to earn income to support your family. Maybe a business, maybe a consultancy, maybe a freelancing business, maybe another job, maybe another 9-to-5 job, whatever it may be. Have an exit plan, a strategy. Don't rush out of your office thinking that, oh, if I quit my job, things will automatically be better. No, be realistic, okay? So those are the three things I would like to share with you with regards to your particular situation. Hopefully it's helpful for other people as well. So thank you very much for asking, and thank you very much for watching. Like this video if you like the content, and please share your thoughts, ideas and comments in the comment section down below. Share this video with anyone in your life whom you think should hear the message of this video. And lastly, subscribe to this YouTube channel to get more videos like this. Now, my name is Aiman Azlan. Assalamualaikum. Bye.